boil dripping, beef fart sniffing, bubble butt.
Who could forget him? As Rufio in Hook, Dante Basco has done a lot since then, and he collected his experiences in a memoir called From Rufio to Zuko. Please welcome Dante Basco. How are you?
Hey, how are you doing? Good morning.
I love this. So explain this. This is so cool. So this is the cover of the book. So you can get either one, right?
Yes.
And so why'd you choose that?
Well, it's From Rufio to Zuko. It's two kind of iconic characters I had the good fortune in my career to play. And
right.
A lot of the, you know, I'm lucky to have fans, multi-generational fans.
Right.
Some fans are more, you know, gravitate towards Rufio, some gravitate towards Zuko, so.
Smart.
Both faces on the book.
So writing a book is hard, and you actually wrote this.
Yes.
How did you do it?
It's hard. I mean, it took me about 2 years. It's hard to confront your life. You know, the publishers, Daniel Lisi from Not a Cult Media, approached me about my story, and I was like, I'm far too young to write.
Right.
Autobiography, memoir,
right,
you know?
Right.
But he really wanted a story about Hollywood in an Asian American perspective. And he's like, you're the kid that we all grew up with, so we want your story. And I thought that was a great idea.
Right.
Until I sat down and started writing.
Yeah. Where do you start? Day one?
Yeah. Well,
right.
I actually started this book, you know, I had a broken, 11-year relationship or broken engagement, and I kind of started there.
Mm. And that's fun to do, right?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. I mean, it gives you, it definitely puts you in a moment of introspection.
Yeah. Right.
Where you start to have flashbacks about your life.
Is there anything surprising we'd learn about you from this book?
Yeah, I think, yes. You know, with all actors and artists in the industry, all our industry of media, if you've been here for over 10 years, and I've been this my 35th year next year.
Right.
In the industry, you know that we all have our own true Hollywood story.
Right.
And so, like, this is mine, and you'll see, just as, you know, there's a lot of ups and downs in the industry, and for me, as a blueprint for the new artists coming to town, especially people of color, but all artists, there's gonna be a lot of mistakes you make. These are just some of mine, and stuff with, you know, culty things in LA, just really big heartbreaks and stuff that damaging for young actors. And actors alike, so it's all in there.
And you're speaking of like an E! Hollywood true story, what was it like working with Robin Williams in Hook?
Man, you know, Robin Williams is, when people ask me that question, I'm always like, you know, he's everything you think of him as. He's actually the genie in Aladdin, that's who he is.
Right.
Wow. Magical stuff can happen when he's around, and when he passed away, rest in peace, Robin, he's just, you know, it was a death of, a whole generation's childhood, but it was the death of my childhood personally, because that's
right.
I grew up with him like that.
And you are also as if you weren't busy enough, you're also directing and starring in a film with your brothers called the Fabulous Filipino Brothers.
Yes.
What is that about?
Yeah, that's a crazy film I wrote with my brothers. It's a kind of a story. It's like a big fat Greek wedding,
right?
Filipino style, but it meets kind of like the calamity of like Pulp Fiction. It's four brothers, four vignettes, a linear story told out of order, all around a Filipino wedding. And we just wrapped 3 weeks ago, and I'm editing right now, so I'm very excited to go through my first editing session.
That is a good pitch line. It's when my big fat Greek wedding meets Pulp Fiction.
There you go.
I can't
imagine.
That's a good
line. I know, that's a twist.
That's a solid. Yeah. All right, so From Rufio to Zuko is out everywhere books are sold. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dante.
Thank you guys so much.
So good to
Happy holidays.
You too.